Got one.
Felix has a great camera voice.
It's great.
If I knew, I could have at least worn a shirt today.
The best thing about being a PhD student? Well, I get a lot of freedom in looking at problems that I think are interesting.
It's nice to have a lot of freedom and really feel like I control my own project and what I want to do with my day.
Once you start, you will realize that there is a lot of freedom. If you feel it's scary and it's a big commitment, I think just take it easy and give it a try.
So my name is Ylva Wahlqvist and I'm a PhD student here at the Department of Automatic Control. And I have done 3 years of research, which is modeling and control of medical systems.
I'm Luka Bakovic. I've been here for a year. So far, I believe I've done nothing but read books, but they keep on paying me, so I guess it's fine. My research is on socio-technical systems, and the easiest way to describe that would be like sociology with a bunch of numbers. So we try to model voting or information exchange between people or social networks and that kind of stuff.
Yes, so our time is spent between teaching, research, and taking courses. So we have 20% teaching, 1.5 years of course credits, 2.5 years of research, which is 5 years in total.
I feel it's just like another job, except that it involves taking courses, so you end up being a student, but it's a lovely job and I like the job.
So this is where I spend most of my time in the office, but once a week I also visit Igelasa, which is a lab outside of Lund, where I do my experiments. So I'm taking a course in algorithms and data structures, which I think can be useful when I'm done. Coding is fun. This is what I am doing, but what I should be doing is writing on my paper. So most of my work I'm doing by myself, but I also work with my supervisor and another PhD student.
And then everybody in the office uses these sort of old theses to like lift their monitor up. And you can tell how long people have been here by the number. So I have a much smaller pile. I have like 1/3 of Ylva's pile because I've only been here for 1 year and she's been here for 3, so. Why I would recommend this department in particular is the super healthy working environment, the really nice administrative staff who help you with everything in your first months, and mostly the fact that you're coming into a department where every office door is open and you can ask almost anybody a question.
This is the office where many people pass every day, I would say. This door is always open. I'm Eva Westin. I'm the administrative manager at the department. And I think you should be a PhD student at this department because they have so much fun.
This is not what we do when we're working.
I enjoy this department because people here are very active in doing fun things surrounding the work. For example, we play floorball together, we have board game nights, we go climbing together. So depending on the season and depending on what you're interested in, you're always going to be able to find someone to do something fun with.
Well, so here at the department, it's very nice to be an international. I mean, of course, people are very welcoming, but they're also very much used to it. So I think 1/3 or so of our PhD students are internationals. There's also professors who are internationals, postdocs as well, admin staff as well. So basically every layer you can think of in the department, there's diversity and there's international people. So they're very used to it.
The international atmosphere and the feeling of inclusiveness and everything is like top notch. So quality work, but also the emotional human side is met as well.
You will get a very, very good supervision from the supervisors. We have weekly meetings and they never push us.
Well, I mean, they push us the right amount.
Yeah, the right amount.
Yeah, but yeah, supervision here is very,
very good.
Very good, yeah. Yes. So top-notch life experience, top-notch research experience as well.
One potential career pathway is to just, I guess, keep on doing the same thing, do something called the postdoc, and then try to look for academic positions. And the other pathway you can do is go into any other sort of industry job, but that really depends on what you did a PhD in, your country, your field, and everything else.
I think if you want to become a PhD student in automatic control, and if you're interested in research, you should go for it.
My only advice would be yeah, go for it.
If you are into it, just go for it.
Every Friday, like as a social activity, you shouldn't have it on camera, but yeah, we meet up in my office and it's called a study circle. We call it a study circle where we study semiconductors. We have a really, really thick book, but in it, it's like a... it's secret. I can show you the